now. It's about 9:30 now. Been waiting off these guys for nearly an hour. Most of them have stood up and sort of relocated their bedding areas. The sun's shifted across the sky, so hopefully the shades are constant and they're just going to stay there. The wind's even better now, so just going to slowly make our way in, and yeah, fingers crossed we can get the job done. Just had those roos go through. They were just bedded up under some trees and we wanted to get under about 50 metres in front of us. And they finally passed through and they haven't disturbed the chital, so we're about 80 metres off them, but they're semi-alert, just looking around. And we'll just give them a bit of time again, just let them sit down, close their eyes and go back to sleep, because most of them are looking this way. And there's not a whole lot of cover, so we'll just take our time and then get in, edge in a bit closer. Thank you.
just looking back on that stalk, it's still pumping. And yeah, I was able to make it into those little green bushes. It was a pretty open stalk from about 80 metres out, but this tusk basalt shirt, like literally in the basalt as we are now, like has done the deed. And I was able to sneak in there and then had to wait for about a few minutes while he was standing, sort of looking my way, but I sort of hugged up against that bush and waited for him to go broadside. And at 28 metres, sent the 175 grain Auscut, and I've taken out the double lung, I'm assuming, and he's made it about 80 metres out the back and piled up, so pretty keen to go have a look at him and get my hands on him.
This particular hunt was a little bittersweet. Walking up to this stag, it quickly became less so about the individual animal and more about achieving the goal of filling the freezer and utilising a valuable resource. The reality was that in the weeks that followed this hunt, multiple helicopter culls were planned, with the intended goal being complete eradication of chital deer on this property. This would result in hundreds of deer being indiscriminately gunned down and left to rot in the dirt. No meat retrieved, no memories or stories forged. Whilst the decision of taking this stag in velvet without seeing him reach his true potential was a difficult one, in the grand scheme of things, the decision was an easy one, knowing the alternate conclusion that would have followed in the weeks to come.